upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Way on where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine.
To get away from her.
I was on Ceres yesterday, all the way out in the asteroid belt, and up she pops, stowed away again.
She's not gonna stop trying until she's made a full space racer.
Hey, guys!
Hi, Starling.
I really, 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 really want to be a space racer.
Well, you know, when you're older.
And I'm tired of not being older.
You know what Headmaster Crane says. The universe wasn't built in a day. It took 13 and a half billion years.
In 13 and a half billion years, I'll be too old. I want to start now.
Well, the first step is taking the safety and space test. But
and that's what I want.
And you'd need a supervisor, because if you don't have a supervisor...
You can be my supervisor, Eagle.
I can't be your supervisor. It has to be the Academy teacher that certifies your test.
Oh, okay. I guess no one will help me. I guess everyone's forgotten how they felt when they were junior cadets.
Fine, we'll help you get trained up.
Yes, yes, yes!
But you'll still have to get Coach Pigeon to certify your test after we train you.
This is so exciting! I can't wait!
Where is everything?
Coach? Hello? I'm here for my training. Hello? Hello, Mr. Vulture and Mr. Dodo. I'm Starling, and I'm gonna be a space racer.
We're looking for Coach Pigeon.
I'm starting my safety in space, thingamy training today.
Yes, well, I'm afraid Coach Pigeon isn't here.
Mr. Vulture has taken over his job.
As chairman of Stardust Space Academy, I've decided I need to be more involved in the lives of our cadets.
So he's voted himself in as the new chief training officer.
You're taking over for Coach Pigeon certifying cadets for their tests?
Yes, of course.
Where's all our training equipment?
We've moved the training equipment away so we can drill for rocket fuel right out of this building.
And the rest of this space will be used for something else.
We're turning it into a private club for zillionaires!
With an indoor cyber golf course.
Also for zillionaires.
So how is Starling supposed to train?
It's going to be difficult, isn't it? I think the best thing would be to wait until Coot designs a replacement training facility, which he will no doubt have completed soon. Perhaps in 9 or 10 years. I'll test her then.
But
goodbye.
But why can't I just do it without all the machines?
Because they help you practice your flying on every planet you can think of.
And you need that for your test.
That all went rather well.
If you ask me, boss.
I didn't.
I think you're taking a really big risk. You know how much you hate spending time with young kids.
Annoying, runny-nosed little creatures.
But if Starling completes her training, you're gonna have to oversee her test.
How could that possibly happen?
Because you've made yourself chief training officer, and that's what chief training officers do.
Don't be a dodo, Dodo. This is a win-win situation. I get all that rocket fuel, and without their fancy pants high-tech equipment, neither Starling nor any other greasy winged little cadet has a chance of completing their training, much less taking the test. It's perfect.
I don't know, boss.
You worry too much. It's never going to happen.
You know what, guys? We're not gonna let Vulture get away with this.
But how can we train her without any equipment?
If we use our heads and what we already know about the planets, I bet we can come up with something.
Yay!
It won't be as exciting as outer space, but you'll get to see some interesting places on Earth.
What's first? Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars? See, I know that. Jupiter, Saturn?
Well, obviously I can't remember every part of the test. So what do we need?
Looks like we need Hawk's memory first.
Hawk's what?
What was the first thing we did when we trained for the safety test?
Oh, that was the extra gravity of Jupiter challenge. I remember we had some amazing fuel juices afterwards.
The bigger the planet, the more gravity it has. I know that.
It means you feel much heavier, and it's a lot more work to escape from Jupiter's gravitational pull.
Kind of like carrying extra weight. Okay, we can arrange that.
Jupiter is the biggest planet in our solar system. It's absolutely ginormous!
Bigger than Earth?
Much. Ava, please post a picture on our screen so we can show Starling.
Affirmative.
There's Jupiter! See how big it is?
So it has a lot more gravity than Earth. So, by my calculations, you should feel more than 2 times heavier.
Like if you ate an entire birthday cake!
You're pretty small, so just over twice your weight would be about...
2 TVs, 3 spare fuel cans, and a barrel of rocket oil.
I hope you're feeling strong, Starling.
Yeah, I'm so excited. I could pull the whole planet Jupiter right now. Wow, it's hard to take off on Jupiter.
We haven't actually put the weights on yet.
Maybe we should start by simulating a smaller planet, like Mars. It's very easy to take off from there.
Yeah, easier than Earth.
I'm really gonna go for it this time.
Don't. You need to take off really gently, because Mars has much less gravity.
Okay, Starling, you can untie the balloons now.
Yay! What's next, guys? The storms of Mars?
Yes. On Mars, the winds get very strong and full of Martian sand, and you need to be able to fly through all that.
And we're going to do that here?
Oh, yes! Wind!
Check!
Sand!
Good to go, Robyn!
I can do this! Oh, look, a butterfly!
Here we are, the North Pole. A lot like the ices of Neptune.
On many planets further from the sun, like Uranus and Neptune, it's so cold that everything's icy, and it can be very slippery to land on.
So just copy what we do. Land slowly using your retro rocket so you don't skid. Yeah, like that, but on the dry land.
Gotcha!
Okay, Starling, let's see how well you've been training.
Asteroid dodging!
If you go beyond Mars, there's a huge asteroid belt you have to fly through. Ready, Eagle?
Release the asteroids! Easy when you know how, right?
Well, I think Starling here is ready for that test. Unfortunately, as you know, I can't conduct a test anymore. So let's go find the new chief training officer.
What did I tell you, Dodo? The anti-gravity machine is the perfect tool to help us get more rocket fuel up out of the ground.
You're so clever, boss. Someday I want a brain just like yours.
Oh, now what? Can't they see I'm working here?
It's Coach Pigeon and those space racers. They say you can give Starling her safety in space test now.
Ah, young Starling. I'm ever so sorry, but as I said before, it's impossible for you to train here. So you'll just have to go home and give up on your dreams.
But we've trained her.
You've what? How nice to hear. A triumph of the rocket spirit, yes! I'd be more than happy to test her. Oh, but alas, no suitable equipment.
So you will test her?
Of course, dear coach. It's an important part of my new job, after all. But with no test facilities here now.
No problem. You can just take it to the nearest test center. We've done that before, you know.
And where is the nearest test center?
Mars? The nearest test center is Mars?
Yay! I'm going to Mars with Mr. Vulture! Isn't that exciting?
And with Eagle, Robin, and Hawk training junior cadets so well, you'll have lots more like Starling to take to Mars every week.
This is all your fault. Make sure Coach Pigeon is back in charge of this place before I get back. If I get back.
But boss, the rocket fuel, the zillionaires.
No amount of rocket fuel is worth this.
And we're gonna have so much fun together, aren't we, Mr. Vulture? How many miles is it to Mars? Why is it so red? Why do you have such a big nose cone? Oh, can you smell better with that? Ooh, we should have a tea party on Mars with Mr. Rocket Man.
Do you think she'll be okay?
Oh, she'll be fine. I'm more worried about poor Vulture.
You're right about that.